Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of the All Pro Show. Captain V here, just playing around a little bit, working on some offshore gear. Love this stuff. To me, it's just like, you know, jewelry or something. I could play with this stuff all day long. But today, I want to talk about a vendor. I want to talk about a product more than anything else that this vendor actually makes. It's going to be at the All Pro Show on February 17th and February 18th. Chatta Lores. And the product that they got is called their Side Tracker Spreader Bar. An absolute must. But I'm going to save the candy for last. I want to talk about the spreader bar because there's a lot more to the spreader bar than what the eye can see. First of all, this spreader bar is made here in the USA. This is not a mass-produced spreader bar that comes from some country overseas or something like that where they mass-produce them and every 100 or so they pull off and look at it, you know, make sure that it consists of enough bar squid bulbs and stuff like that. No, this is a Chatta Lore made right here. Each and every spreader bar is inspected. Each crimp is looked at, is inspected, is tested. Everything is looked at. They want to eliminate any failure when you're off 50, 80, 100 miles out into the ocean. You're at the canyon. You know, you don't want failure. They make sure that you're not going to have a problem with their product. So first, let's talk about a little bit. Military gray titanium bar. This is the 19-inch version. They make 36 inches. I'm not showing you the 36 because it's just easier for me to show you the 19. Plus, I love this bar here. The hardware. I got to get you a close-up of this. Super, super great heavy-duty hardware. Not going anywhere. Also, stainless steel. Not rusting. You're not going to come back next season and it's not going to swivel or move. It's really solid. Again, the crimps. These are bench crimps. Diamond bench crimps on here. They're not moving. They're not going anywhere. It's not like you got some factory worker there that's just, you know, with a hand crimp and just crimping some stuff. It wasn't that long ago that I was pulling a spreader bar and my birds over here, this crimp gave away and it went into this bulb here. And next you know, I got a bird flying down here somewhere and the bar's all messed up. Not going to happen with a Chatta Lore. Not going to happen. You're not going to see that happen. 150-pound mono. Super great stuff. This is on your teaser. Really good. On this one here, I have it set up with squid bulbs. These will float. I like these. I fish a lot of calm water, and I like these being on top. If I'm fishing more turbulent water, rougher water, you know, I'll go with a machine squid. The machine squid is a solid squid. It's a heavier squid. It will sit in the water. It will hold your spreader bar a little bit more in the water, so the rough water, turbulent water, doesn't throw it all over the place. Great bar, great setup. The stinger line, or the main line, 200 pounds. That's what we're talking about. You're not going to lose a fish off of this. 200 pounds mono. Again, great crimps, plenty of action. But let's talk about the 250-pound AFW ball bearing swivel. You don't get better quality. This is in the water all the time. You got to have something dependable. This is it. They don't make them better. Great product, great quality. And again, Chatta Lores, they put that, you know, they're not going to nickel and dime you. They got the chafing tube right where it needs to be. Again, great product. What I like about this, hey, today you're fishing off a squid. This one's set up right now with a squid. Here's your machine squid I was talking about a little earlier. Look solid. You want it solid. You want it to sit down in the water a little bit while the teasers are flapping or making a mess and making all the racket and noise. You want this one to sit in the water and track it a little bit. They got them set up for tournament. Perfect setup with the hook. They use an 8-0 VMC hook. You know, do you get better quality than that? If you do, let me know about it because to me, that's the name of the game right there. Supersonic hook. But going back to the swivel here. Hey, you're pulling this, not working for you. You notice, hey, there's a herring or ballyhoo in the water. You're seeing some stuff. You want to switch it out. Not a big deal. There you go. You switch it out. you put another stinger on, you go, you might want to run a sand eel of some kind off there, a rig ballyhoo, skirted, unskirted, naked, doesn't matter, you put it on, you make it happen, you send it right back out. Great spreader bar. But now let's talk about the candy. Yup, it's all about the candy. They call this the side tracker. I call it bi-directional. They utilize a word called side tracker. This is a patented device that Jason Braun and Chad Allois uses. What's special about this? Well, the 19 inches I run on the outside off my outriggers deep. I do that because they're light. I'm not going to get false clips popping on me where I have to reel everything in again because there's too much pressure on the line from the spreader bar. So you're not going to get that with this. It's light. Also, I like to run them on the outside, especially with this side track and this bi-directional, because what it's going to do, it's going to push it even further. So if this wasn't here and you're using your spreader bar, your spreader bar is tracking right behind the line. So if you're going to have it on the outrigger, it's going to look like this. But for me, with this here, I run it out here. And that's the way it moves. The water will push against this and move that spreader bar to the outside. So what does that do? That allows me now to run additional spread inside, additional lures inside, some daisy chains. I run a 36-inch spreader bar bi-directional just like this, closer up. Now, that one's also the outside. Now you can make your turns, you can run 10, 12 lines, you make your turns, right to left, port to starboard. You're not tangling up, you're not going over everything because they are going to stay to the outside. You know what? Hey, you want to run rainbow to starboard. All right, no big deal. This is what they have here, a little switch. You pop this little mechanism like that, it pulls down, doesn't get much easier. You lock it in, done. Guess what? This is tracking. It's pulling to starboard now. And that's how this is going to run. It's absolutely beautiful. You get a moment, go on YouTube, Google, or, you know, search for Chad Allois. They have some videos on how these actually run. And you'll see them run like that. Hey, if you're going to be going tuna fishing, if you're going to be on the water, you got to think quality and you got to be prepared. You know, I've had other side tracking or bi-directional spreader bars. They're good. They work. Problem, just even last year, one of these broke. So now I have one that's running straight, and I don't have anything I can run on the starboard side. Everything I got is port now. So my port side is running straight. My starboard's wide. I can't run, you know, as many lines I want on the inside. If I had my boat just full of chatter, boom, I pop it, I turn it. Well, there we go. We got one here. We got one there. We got them up front. It's absolutely great. You're going to love this product. They're going to be at the All Pro Show. Big, big booth. Justin Braun, he's going to be there himself. He's the guy that actually checks all these out before they go out to any tackle store or anywhere before they're being sold. Talk to him. The guy is golden. He's going to tell you exactly what you need, and he's never going to steer you wrong. So speak with Justin. Come to the show February 17th, February 18th. Big display, every color imaginable. Great product. I will see you there.